ladies and gentlemen. That was the 10 o'clock news.
Ricky's mother and father have come home late from shopping this evening. Ricky's grandmother is sleeping on the couch, and the television is still on. But they're not happy to see Ricky still up at 10:30. He should have gone to bed at 8:30. Did he take his bath? Did he finish his arithmetic paper? Well, no time for all that now. It'll have to wait until morning. But in the morning, when Mother wakes him up to get ready for school, Ricky is still tired. You know why. The bathroom won't be empty for long. Everyone else is getting ready for the day, except Ricky. Lucky for him, his sister just came by. He's going to be late. But now his brother is in the bathroom. He'll have to get dressed before he washes up. But he wants a red shirt to match the shirt his friend Pete is going to wear. Where's his red shirt? He should have asked yesterday. Now it's there with the other ironing. No time to iron it this morning. Ricky's gotten dressed fast. He still hasn't washed. Uh-oh, his arithmetic. Everyone's eating breakfast. But where's Ricky? Working his jigsaw puzzle. He hasn't even washed up yet. No wonder his mother is angry. And he still hasn't finished his arithmetic. He doesn't even have time to eat his breakfast. What a way to get ready for school. And that was a good breakfast his mother made for him, too. He didn't comb his hair, he didn't brush his teeth, but even worse, he forgot his arithmetic paper, which he didn't even finish. That's not being very responsible. Late again. This happens often, and yet Ricky doesn't know why. We do. After school, Ricky's friend Pete is waiting for him. Ricky's going to spend the night at Pete's house. He'll go to school right from there. His teacher gave him one more chance to finish his arithmetic. So he'll do it tonight. We hope. At Pete's house that evening, Ricky has enjoyed the dinner and thanks Pete's mother. Ricky and Pete were building a city before dinner. Ricky wants to finish it now. No, there's something else Pete wants to do first. This book is due at the school library tomorrow. Pete wants to be sure he finishes it this evening. Doesn't Ricky have something to do himself? His arithmetic? He ought to do it now to be sure it's ready for school tomorrow. And so, not much later, Pete has finished his book and Ricky has finished his arithmetic. Now they can build their city, can't they? What does Pete want to do now? This is the hall table. Pete always puts things here that he wants to take to school. That seems like a good idea to Ricky, too. Now the city can get built. They have lots of time. It's only 7 o'clock, and Pete doesn't go to bed until 8:30. But at 7:30, Pete's mother says it's time to start getting ready for bed. But they still have an hour. Of course. That's why now is the time to start. They both want to take showers. Pete's mother gave Ricky his own towel and told him where to hang it. They want to have milk and cookies, too. That takes time. But they've given themselves enough time to do all the things they need to do to get ready for tomorrow. By 8:15, they're finished. And there's still some time left to play checkers. It seems to Ricky that he never has this much time at home. Now Pete's mother wants to help Pete get his clothes ready for tomorrow. Ricky knows that's a good idea. His mother usually helps him do that at home, too. Is there anything else the boys need? Did Pete's mother remember the jar he needs for school? She's glad he reminded her. It'll be on the hall table for Pete in the morning. A triple jump! Ricky wins that game. How about another? Is there time? No, it's after 8:30. Not even for just one more game? Not if they want to get the sleep they need. Good night. Good morning. 7:30. Time to get up. Pete gets right up. Ricky isn't used to getting up when his mother wakes him, but he's not as tired as usual. They have to use the bathroom now. Pete's brother will want to use it in a little while. Ricky knows which towel is his. It's right where he left it last night. Putting all his clothes out the night before makes it easy to get dressed fast. This is Pete's brother. He's come to tell them that breakfast is almost ready. But Pete seems to need a little help. The snap won't close. There. It's a good idea to get help when you need it. Pete's hair needs combing. So does Ricky's, and he has a comb. His mother planned ahead for him. Where's Pete going? Oh, to hang up his pajamas. Time for breakfast. Ricky likes cereal and toast, too. Is there enough time to eat? Lots of time. They don't have to leave until 8:30. Imagine a breakfast where you don't have to hurry. Ricky likes that. Where's Pete? Oh, here he is. He got the paper. That's his regular job. It helps his mother. Ricky notices that Pete's mother doesn't have to tell him to do things all the time, the way his mother does. You feel more grown up when you don't have to be reminded all the time. Breakfast is fun at Pete's house. Now it's time to leave for school. The things they want to take with them are on the hall table. Ricky will pick up his pajamas after school. Ricky likes Pete's way of getting ready for school. He's going to try it. Can he do it? Getting ready for school begins the night before. Grandma thinks that someone must be sick. Ricky isn't sick. He's just trying to get ready for school the way Pete does. Everyone thinks that's a good idea. He keeps trying the next morning. Thank you. Today, Ricky has enough time to eat all his breakfast with his family. Everyone likes this new Ricky. After breakfast, he even has time to talk to his father before he goes to work. He doesn't forget the paper he wants to take to school. It's going to be a wonderful day. Was it hard getting ready for school this new way? Yes. Breaking old habits is always hard. Perhaps Ricky won't be as good every day as he was today, but he's going to keep on trying.